Welcome to Fix It Home Improvement, covering projects that every homeowner should know and great products for home and garden.
Hi, I'm JC, and this is where we share weekly home improvement tips. I'm here with my co-host, Cindy.
Hello, JC.
Hi, Cindy. This week, we're going to talk about hummingbirds, and we'd like to thank Stephanie S. for liking and sharing the podcast. And Cindy is working hard on our 11th home improvement ebook. It's called Home Improvement Solutions, What Every Homeowner Should Know. And you can check out and download our other 10 ebooks on Amazon. Hummingbird-like fossils have been discovered in Germany, and they date back around 30 million years. And hummingbirds died out in Europe and almost everywhere except North, Central, and South America. So one of the earliest descriptions of hummingbirds was in the 1500s when European explorers wrote about the animals they found. President Theodore Roosevelt kept a checklist of all the birds he saw around the White House, and a ruby-throated hummingbird is on his list.
Exciting.
There are over 300 species of hummingbirds in North, Central, and South America, and they range in size from around 2.5 inches to 8 inches long, and they range in weight from around 3 to 20 grams, and most weigh about 5 grams. So a nickel weighs 4.5 grams.
Huh.
Crazy, huh? The average hummingbird will live 3 to 5 years, with a few species living up to 10 years. They come in a wide range of colors and patterns. Many have feathers that have a metallic scale-like look to them. And the wings in their back are usually going to be green, gray, blue, reddish-brown, or brown. Male hummingbirds have brightly colored feathers and a patch of color on their necks, and it can be red, purple, orange, blue, or pink, and most will have thin, pointed beaks.
That are scary looking.
Hummingbirds have evolved to have very small, lightweight feet, so it's easier for them to fly. And they mainly use their feet to perch, so they don't walk or hop very much. And their tongues are grooved in a W shape with tiny hairs, and it helps them draw nectar up using a capillary action.
That's weird.
Yeah, and they can lick 10 to 15 times a second.
Hmm.
Scientists think that they don't have a very well-developed sense of smell, but they have great eyesight and memory so that it's easy for them to remember where they found sources of food. And they're attracted to shapes and colors. Hummingbirds can hover, fly backwards, side to side. In fact, they're the only bird that can fly backwards. They can flap their wings 50 to 100 times a second. And you can actually hear a buzzing sound coming off their wings because they're flapping so fast. Many can fly 30 miles an hour, with a few species flying up to 50 miles an hour.
Outrageous.
They have a heart rate of around 1,200 beats a minute, and they need to consume about half their body weight in bugs and nectar every day. So they'll eat 5 to 8 times an hour, and at night when they sleep, or if it's cold weather, they can lower their metabolism by about 85%.
Wow.
Cornell University says researchers have documented that small hummingbirds have been caught and killed by large dragonflies, frogs, praying mantises, and they found some trapped in spider webs. Bird watchers say that hummingbirds have a bad temper. So they'll chirp and fly in front of birds or animals in their territory. And if they want to attack, they'll fly above an intruder and dive into them with their needle-like beaks.
See, I told you they were scary.
Which can kill small birds. So one suggestion, if you're feeding hummingbirds, is to space out hummingbird feeders. And that helps keep their temper in check.
Do they attack each other?
Yeah, they say they're very territorial. With most hummingbirds, after they mate, the female makes the nest and raises the young, and they're building the nest out of twigs, leaves, plant fibers, if they find string anywhere. And hummingbirds figured out to go to a spider's web and get spider silk to bind this all together and anchor it to a tree branch. And the spider silk is helping repel water. And it's flexible, so when they lay their eggs, it expands to hold on to the eggs, and it expands as the baby birds grow. Amazing, isn't it?
Yes.
Females are usually laying two eggs, and the newborns will stay in the nest for a few weeks, and they depend completely on their mother to feed them nectar and insects and keep them warm at night. Most of the hummingbird species don't migrate except for the North American species that fly south for winter, and many of the hummingbirds that mate in Canada and Alaska will migrate down to Mexico in the winter. So birdwatchers say that many people think keeping hummingbird feeders out will prevent hummingbirds from migrating, but scientists say it's not true. When the length of daylight reaches a certain threshold, it triggers hormones that stimulate the hummingbird to migrate, and they say having feeders out for migrating birds helps provide the needed food and energy. Hummingbirds that fly across the Gulf of Mexico will fly nonstop for 20 hours to get across.
Well, where are they going to stop?
Right, they can't. But how crazy is that, that they can fly for 20 hours straight?
It's outrageous.
The Tennessee University Extension says ruby-throated hummingbirds have a diet of around 50% flower nectar and 50% insects and other invertebrates most of the year, but they'll consume even more insects during the nesting season for protein, vitamins, minerals, and fat. Mm. And they love mosquitoes, spiders, gnats, fruit flies, small bees, insect larvae, aphids, and insect eggs. And with some other species, insects are only around 30% of their diet until they migrate, and then they bulk up on more insects for protein and fat. They recommend if you're feeding hummingbirds, don't use insecticides in your yard or purchase plants that are pre-treated with insecticides. Friends of the Earth International says new research suggests pesticides are contributing to the decline of honeybees and hummingbirds, which are both important pollinators. Many plants at home centers and garden centers are pre-treated with pesticides now. And some of the most popular pesticides for keeping bugs out of your home are using neonicotinoids, which can be deadly to bees and hummingbirds. So they're suggesting when you're using a pesticide for border control, don't spray near flowering plants or flowers, don't spray on windy days, and don't spray near feeders or bird baths.
Okay.
I spoke to Perky Pet. They make hummingbird feeders, and they gave me some tips for attracting hummingbirds.
Did you spell yet in this episode?
Perky Pet. P-E-R-K-Y, capital P-E-T. They say add red flowers to your landscape area and flower gardens. Research shows that hummingbirds have a heightened sensitivity to yellow and red. And also, they think there may be some conditioning because most manufacturers make red hummingbird feeders. And they have good memories that they might be drawn to red because of that also. Hang brightly colored ribbons near feeders that will attract their attention. And when you're purchasing feeders, look for feeding ports and tops that are colored red and they can be seen from above. Use multiple feeders in your yard. It'll help prevent territorial disputes and you can get multiple birds around your home.
Exciting.
Leave spider webs alone because hummingbirds will pick insects off the webs and then use the web for their nests. Have landscape flowers that attract a variety of insects and plant flower gardens or landscape areas with flowers that will bloom at different times throughout the season. The University of Maine says when you're selecting plants for hummingbirds, choose flowers that are tubular, odorless, and brightly colored. And when you're planting them, put them in tiers. So you have your low plants in front, your medium plants behind them, and the tallest plants at the back of a garden or a landscape area. And that gives the hummingbirds room to get to the nectar. And avoid insecticides, which can poison plants and insects. The Tennessee State University says besides flowers, insects, and feeders, hummingbirds are looking for water. And they're attracted to the fine mist that comes from water hoses or bird baths that have a mister. Hummingbirds like to bathe in shallow water, so if you have a bird bath, only keep it about a quarter inch deep. And a small bird bath or a shallow...
Yeah, they're so drunk, they're so tiny.
Right. So get a small bird bath or a shallow pan near a food source, and that will help attract hummingbirds to your area. Penn State University says hummingbirds like to bathe by flying through a fine mist of water, and even though they get water from feeders, they need a clean source of pure water to drink. The Hummingbird Society says hummingbirds don't use birdhouses for nests, so they suggest having some nesting material around if you're feeding them. And there's a product called Hummer Helper. It's H-U-M-M-E-R, capital H-E-L-P-E-R. This is a nesting material that you can get at some bird stores or garden centers.
There's bird stores?
Yes, bird store. That's where you get your bird feed and your bird hummingbird nectar. The National Wildlife Federation says if you're leaving out nesting material for hummingbirds like yarn and string, use raw cotton, hemp, sisal, or wool that's cut into 6-inch sections. Don't use synthetic fiber or long lengths. Dog fur works well for birds, but don't leave out human hair, because human hair is too thin and it can wrap around the bird's legs or neck, causing injury or even death. And don't use dog fur that's been treated with flea or insect repellents. Don't leave out dryer lint. It retains moisture and may contain detergent, softeners, or other chemicals that are unhealthy for birds. And you can put this material in a suet feeder, and that way the birds can find it and use it.
Exciting.
Wild Bird Magazine says researchers found that hummingbirds' survival depends on eating more frequently than any other animal, and they're in a constant battle to survive. Because if they don't get enough food during the day, they can die. And they have to go into a hibernation-like state at night to reduce their metabolic rate so they can survive through the night. Seems like a lot of work. If you plan on feeding hummingbirds, there are two main types of feeders. One style is a dish or a saucer feeder, and this will usually have a cover with flower-shaped feeding ports, and that catches the bird's attention. The other style is a bottle feeder, and this will have a bottle connected to a base with feeding ports. And the bottle feeders can either be a top fill or a bottom fill, where you would remove the bottle from the base. And one of the first hummingbird feeders, it was developed by Mary Rogers Webster, who was a naturalist, and her husband. They started experimenting with designs in 1928, and when an article showed off their design of this glass feeder with two red feeding tubes on the bottom in 1948, they started getting orders for them, so they started making them and selling them for $10 each, which was a lot of money in 1948. It'd be like $100 each in today's dollars.
That's crazy.
Yeah, funny, huh? The University of Arizona suggests buying a red feeder because they found that yellow feeders can attract more bees and wasps. The Hummingbird Society says take the time to compare feeders and how easy they are to take apart and clean, because maintenance is very important with hummingbird feeders. They suggest changing the sugar mixture every 4 to 5 days, and even more often in hot weather. A lot of other manufacturers recommend changing the sugar mixture at least once a week, and then more often in hot weather. Look for a feeder that has feeding ports above the liquid to avoid drips that will attract bees and ants. And use multiple feeders or feeders with multiple ports to reduce territorial disputes. Cornell University says to help attract hummingbirds to a feeder, plant perennial flowers that produce deep-throated orange or red flowers.
What does that mean, deep-throated?
So they're elongated flowers. So a hummingbird is attracted to that. They're going to stick their long beak and their head into a long flower, and that helps pollinate it, too. You want to hang the feeder near flowers and where the color or the shape of the feeding ports can be seen from above. Hummingbirds prefer feeders near plants or trees that they can use as cover from predators, or it gives them a place to perch and get out of the sun. Shade or partial shade will help keep the feeding solution from spoiling as quickly, and keep it high enough to prevent cats and other predators from reaching up to the feeder, and put it at a height where it's easy to remove for cleaning and filling.
Okay.
You can use string or cord and hang it off a tree, or you can use one of those freestanding hooks that you would use for plants and hang it in a landscape area or a flower garden. And there's also hangers for plants that you could attach to a fence or a post, and then hang your feeder off of that.
Okay.
The University of Maine says you can make an artificial nectar for your hummingbird feeder by mixing one part table sugar with 4 parts boiling water. After you let it cool, you can put it into your feeder and then refrigerate the extra nectar, and you'd want to replace that after 1 week. And don't use red food coloring. It can cause health problems in hummingbirds.
Huh. Oh, no.
The Hummingbird Society says the best hummingbird nectar is 1 cup of white cane sugar with 3 to 4 cups of spring water.
Can you use tap water?
Yeah, but it's not going to be the best nectar. This mixture can be stored for 1 week. They say don't add food coloring. Do not use any other type of sugar. So don't use raw, powdered, brown, or organic sugar. And never use honey or artificial sweeteners. Clean your feeder every time you fill it. You don't want to just top it off without cleaning it.
Clean it with what?
You want to use a mild detergent and water, and then make sure you're rinsing it thoroughly. And if the solution appears cloudy or if it looks moldy, you want to make sure you wash it thoroughly right away. Then once a month, or if it's moldy, you want to use a solution of 1 tablespoon of bleach in 1/4 water, and then make sure you rinse it thoroughly. The University of Maine says a diluted bleach solution will kill mold and bacteria, and vinegar is not an adequate substitute for hummingbird feeders. The feeder must be thoroughly rinsed and allowed to air dry because soap or bleach residue left in the feeder can harm hummingbirds. There's a hummingbird feeder called Humbug. It's Humm-Bug. So you throw banana peels and other fruit and vegetables into this. It attracts fruit flies and other insects, and the hummingbirds love it. And you can put that near your nectar feeder. You can also just cut the top off of a plastic jug and hang it up by your feeder, and then throw some fruit or vegetable scraps into it, and that'll attract bugs for your hummingbirds.
Cool, I guess.
Some top-rated hummingbird feeders are from Perky Pet. First Nature, it's F-I-R-S-T, Nature. Aspects, A-S-P-E-C-T-S. Parasol, P-A-R-A-S-O-L. Grateful Gnome, and More Birds, M-O-R-E, capital B-I-R-D-S.
Do you have anything else to add?
Well, it's interesting. When I was looking at the hummingbird feeders, they come in a variety of shapes and colors. You can get
mostly red.
Right, but some of these blown glass, pretty amazing, the variety of colors and shapes, very decorative, so you should check them out online.
Let's wrap this up.
You can subscribe to our podcast on Apple Podcasts, Google Podcasts, CastBox, or your favorite podcast app.
If you enjoyed it, please leave us a review.
You can check out our home improvement videos on our YouTube channel, Fix It Home Improvement.
And you can subscribe to that as well.
You can download our ebooks, Home Improvement Solutions, What Every Homeowner Should Know, Books 1 through 10, and soon Book 11 on Amazon.
If you enjoyed it, please give us a 5-star rating and review.
You can email us at fixitpodcast@gmail.com. You can follow Cindy on Twitter at fixitcohost. And you can follow us on Instagram, Fix It Home Improvement.
Thank you for listening.
Talk to you next week. Into